continues with our Eucharistic prayer which seats in creation. And this Celtic prayer includes a prayer of preparation and then an invitation, and then we get to the Eucharistic. As if this were the only time, and this the only place, and we the only people, Jesus Christ will meet us. As if this were the only time, and this the only place, and we the only people, let us worship God. Let us pray. Heaven is here and earth, and the space is thin between them. Distance may divide, but Christ's promise unites those of us still bounded by time and those who are now blessed by eternity. Let heaven be glad.
Let the whole earth cry glory.
Heaven is here and earth, and the church above and below is one. Peter and the disciples are here, and Paul, Martha, and all the Marys, St. Francis and St. Clair, Mother Teresa, Rachel Carson and John Moore, the saints from far back and those who left us not long ago, Genevieve, Dutchie, Myrtle, and Marcia are here, and only sight prevents us from seeing them. But they are one with us on the other side. Let heaven be glad.
Let the whole earth cry glory.
Heaven is here and earth, and God who made them is present. The Lamb, glorious on the throne, sits beside us. The Spirit of God of the Dove makes her resting place among us. God inhales the breath of our prayers and spreads the table for our satisfaction. Let heaven be glad.
Let the whole earth cry glory.
Blessing and honor and glory and power be to our God forever and ever.
Amen.
Jesus was always the guest in the homes of Peter and Jairus, Martha and Mary, Joanna and Susanna and Zacchaeus. He was always the guest at the meal table of the wealthy, where he fled the case of the poor. He was always the guest. But here at this table, Jesus is the host. Those who wish to serve him must first be served by him. Those who want to follow him must first be fed by him. Those who would wash his feet must first let him make them clean. For this is the table where God intends us to be nourished. This is the time when Christ can make us new. So come, you who are tired and in need of rest. Those of you who hunger and thirst for a deeper faith, for a better life, for a fairer world. Jesus Christ, who has sat at our tables, now invites us to be guests at his table. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Bring them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
We thank you, Holy Creator, that you allow us surrounded by the evidence of your divinity at St. Peter's. Your sun pours in through the tall, clear windows, light and shadows playing across these holy walls and holy words like the joys and sorrows that come and go in our lives. We thank you for the ever-shifting beauty of the Rappahannock River, for the shade of the sycamores, for the flowers that bloom in their season, for the smell of newly cut grass, for the crunch of autumn leaves. We thank you for the laughter and the tears that we have shared together. As Jesus was, we are called to times of service, but also to solitude, to vast stores of unused quiet, to be with you, to immensities of rivers, oceans, and skies that enlarge our souls and remind us of eternity and of what passes, but with promise. And so we come together today to receive your word and join with saints and angels in a chorus of praise and thanks that rings to eternity, lifting our voices to magnify you as we and love as one of us. Setting our wisdom, our will, and our words aside, emptying our hearts and bringing nothing in our hands, we yearn for the rest and the healing, the holding, the accepting, the forgiving which Christ alone can offer. Merciful God, send now in kindness your Holy Spirit to settle on the thread of mind and fill them with the fullness of Jesus. And let that same Spirit rest on us, converting us from the patterns of this passing world until we conform to the shape of Him whose food we now share. Among friends gathered around the table, Jesus took the bread and broke it. This is my body, broken for you. Later, he took the cup of wine and said, this is the new relationship with God made possible because of my death. Take it, all of you, so that I may be present in your midst. Jesus, firstborn of Mary,
have mercy upon us.
Savior of the world,
have mercy upon us.
Jesus, Lord of heaven,
grant us peace.
He whom the universe cannot contain is present to us in this bread. He who redeemed us and called us by name now meets us in this cup. So take this bread and wine, and then God comes to us, so that we may come to God.
Amen.